Welcome to another video of Ancient Greece Reloaded. In this video we are going to discuss the topic of public cults versus private cults, like the Eleusinian Mysteries in Ancient Greece. Also, we will clarify the highly misunderstood idea by mainstream researchers of orgies. Before we jump into it, remember to like our video and to subscribe to our channel, so as to spread the word and to support the project of Ancient Greece Reloaded. To the topic at hand. The first thing that you guys need to keep in mind is that this topic is enormous. Nevertheless, we will try to summarize the main points of it in one video and by keeping it as short as possible. When studying ancient Greece, you should have come across cults that were public and cults that were private. The main questions that pop up here are the following ones. What differentiates the two types of cults? What were public cults and what were private cults? What was their impact on society? What was truly going on in society's backstage and what did happen to them? The public cults. The public cults were pretty much your typical mainstream religions / churches, and even though there were temples etc. that were dedicated to this god or that goddess, overall, they all belonged to one all-encompassing religious system, a system that was generally accepted by all city-states of ancient Greece. Keep in mind, guys, that a generally accepted religious system is one of the factors that is required to rule over the masses. Consequently, the public cults represented that factor. Moreover, pretty much everyone was allowed to enter the spheres of the public cults, and even though there were temples that allowed entrance to only females or males, in essence and overall, when speaking about public cults, there were virtually no entrance restrictions. What mattered to the public cults were basically two things: influence and gold. As long as the masses accepted their doctrines, believed in them and were willing to make offerings to the gods, everything was fine. What is more, public cults were also involved in matters of what we nowadays understand as magic, like love potions or creating various spells or chants, so as for someone to accomplish something, to create curses, to construct protection artifacts, necromancy, etc. And yes, guys, in ancient Greece these types of cults were booming. It should not surprise an investigator that even contemporary Western occult circles, when creating their spells, they also make use of the ancient Greek language. That being said, before moving into the matter of private cults, we need to clarify a misunderstanding that has been adopted by virtually all mainstream researchers. And that is the term of orgy or orgies, plural. It is very important to understand it because it is closely related to the private cults, such as the Eleusinian Mysteries, the Cabirian Mysteries, the Bacchic Mysteries, etc. Nowadays, when someone refers to the term orgy, the people that have no idea of ancient Greek language, or the ones that just rely on mainstream sources, or the ones that have not studied in-depth history, understand it as something related to sex. Guys, be very careful here. Nothing, literally nothing, could be farther away from the truth than that. So let us examine it quickly. The first thing that you guys need to keep in mind is that in ancient Greek language, the words and even its letters do not leave any room for misunderstandings. For example, each word has a specific meaning, so let us push it further and take a word from contemporary Greek, astronaut, astronaftis, which derives from the words astro, star, and naftis, sailor. Hence, astronaut means the sailor of the stars. The meanings are specific and clear-cut. No room for speculations, no room for misunderstandings. The same applies for the ancient Greek language. Consequently, what does the word orgio, aka orgy, mean? The word orgio derives from eorga, erdo, erga, which means to do something, to work on something, to execute a work. Iera erdo, holy orgy, refers to sacrifice and to offer something to the gods. It is similar to the offerings that the Christians do during a ceremony. In other words, so as for someone to perform an orgy, he or she would have to pray, to meditate, to perform fasting, to abstain from sex-related stuff, etc. Something that usually monks do. As a final note, from the word orgy also derive the words of plowing the earth, orgomatizis. As you can see, the word orgy and what an orgy stands for has nothing to do with what people nowadays believe that it does. So how was the principle of orgy been twisted to such an extent? Thanks to historical records, we can pinpoint the reason to the following three factors. Due to the Roman Empire and due to some emperors like Caligula, who turned the ideas of symposium and orgy into sexual parties. Keep in mind, guys, that although the Roman Empire did conquer Greece, in return, it was conquered by ancient Greek intellect. Eventually, the Romans started to twist everything into their own volition. Another factor was the Byzantine Empire and Christianity. The new mainstream religion of the Byzantine Empire was Christianity. Consequently, and so as to control the masses, they went on to destroy the ancient world, which in a sense was opposing them. Therefore, they literally demonized everything and twisted all meanings regarding the ancient Greek religious cults. After a certain point in time, the Byzantine Empire, together with the Christian Church, started something like a witch hunt against the ancient Greek world. The aforementioned two factors, together with inaccurate translations, inaccurate generalizations, and misunderstandings of the ancient Greek world and language, led to all this confusion. Add to it the various paintings throughout the centuries and you get the idea. Now, having clarified all this, let us move on to the topic of private cults. The private cults. In contrast to the public cults, the private cults were on a whole different level. To begin with, not everyone could enter the private cults. For someone to be accepted, he or she would have to pass some kind of test, and success was not guaranteed. If the person was successful, then he would be accepted into the cult. The private cults, even though they had their own hierarchical system, like levels of initiation, they were mainly divided in two circles, the outer circle and the inner circle. In other words, even though someone would make it into the private cult, the person would have to prepare himself so as to pass more tests of initiation, so as to move up in ranks, and eventually to be accepted into the inner circle. Usually, the time frame to make it into the inner circle was between 3 to 7 years, depending on the cult. Furthermore, the private cults did take part in various official festivals. Nevertheless, this was only part of the ceremonies that were meant for the uninitiated ones to see. In general, their teachings, their knowledge, etc. was only meant for the members of their cult. No member was allowed to make public the cult's esoteric knowledge. The penalty for disobeying this rule was usually death. Moreover, many ancient Greek philosophers and Greeks that we highly respect and we study today were initiated in at least one private cult, such as Plato, Pindar, Plutarch, Philip II, Alexander the Great, Pythagoras, etc. Consequently, when one of them wanted to talk about one of the cult's mysteries to the masses, then he or she used various types of stories or allegories. Such is the famous story of Plato's cave. To top everything off, most of the ancient Greek heroes were also initiated in at least one private cult, like Hercules or Orpheus. At this point, please note something very important, guys. The Bacchic orgies and all similar ones, with all their dancing and drinking, did not have anything to do with sexual stuff, as the mainstream claims, but they were aiming to get someone into a state of trance. To help you understand it better, imagine like the Sufi ruling of the so-called dervishes. What is more, if someone managed to enter one of the private cults, then his prestige skyrocketed. This is how much people respected and stood in awe towards the private cults, something that the public cults did not like so much. To summarize, if someone would want to explain the main difference between the public cults and the private cults, then it can be explained as follows. The public cults were geared towards the masses and in a sense represented the mainstream religious beliefs. On the other hand, the private cults were something like a closed club for the few and were focused mainly on what we nowadays call esoteric teachings, chakra awakening, energy control and manipulation, invocations, altered states of existence, etc. How can we be so sure about it? This is the question now. If you guys study carefully all existing material, historical or mythological records, and every time you see private cults appearing and observe the stories or philosophical talks regarding them, it is not so difficult to realize all the aforementioned stuff. Finally, and before closing the video, what were the main reasons that led to the private cult's ruin? Starting off with ancient Greece, it was mainly due to jealousy, greed, and fear from both the public cults and the elites of that time. To help you understand it better, as it happens today, many leaders of that time requested the guidance and wisdom of many private cults, and due to their hidden and advanced knowledge, the private cults were able to provide the leaders with accurate advices that helped the leaders to successfully deal with various problems. Long story short, the private cults were able to accumulate a lot of wealth and an incredible amount of influence in matters of politics. This, of course, the various elites didn't like, as well as being afraid of how this could play out in the long run, they eventually decided to gradually start attacking the private cults. This was actually the main reason behind the demise of the Pythagoreans. Eventually, the Roman Empire came that desired their wealth and influence, and consequently, a large number of the private cults diminished. The final nail to the coffin was given by the Byzantine Empire and Christianity, which pretty much finished off the private cults. And at this point we have reached the end of our video. Please do not forget to like our video and to subscribe to our channel so as to support the project of Ancient Greece Reloaded. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for our upcoming videos.